With all this background on the event-driven model, we will now talk about the Flash paper. Flash is an event-driven web server that follows the AMPAT model. So basically, it has asymmetric helper processes to deal with the blocking I/O operations. In the discussion so far, we really described the architecture of Flash. So it uses helper processes for blocking I/O operations, and then everything else is implemented as an event dispatcher with handlers performing different portions of the web servicing tasks. Given that we're talking about a web server, and this is the old-fashioned Web 1.0 technology where basically the web server just returns static files, the blocking I/O operations that are happening in the system are really just discrete. So the server just reads files that the clients request. The communication from the helpers to the event dispatcher is performed via pipes. The helper reads the file in memory via the mmap call. And then the dispatcher checks via an operation mincore if the pages of the file are in memory. And it then uses this information to decide if it should just call one of the local handlers or if it should pass the request to the helper. As long as the file is in memory, reading it, it won't result in a blocking I/O operation, and so passing it to the local handlers is perfectly okay. Although this is an extra check that has to be performed before we read any file, it actually results in big savings because it prevents the full process from being blocked if it turns out that a blocking I/O operation is necessary. Now we will outline some additional detail regarding some of the optimization that Flash applies. And this will help us later understand some of the performance comparisons. The important thing is that these optimizations are really relevant to any web server. First of all, Flash performs application-level caching at multiple levels. And it does this on both data and computation. What we mean by this is it's common to cache files. This is what we call data caching. However, in some cases, it makes sense to cache computation. So in the case of the web server, the requests are requests for some files. These files need to be repeatedly looked up, so we need to find the file, traverse the directory, look up some of the directory data structures. That processing will compute some result, so some location, some path name for the file, and we will just cache that. We don't have to recompute that and look up the same information next time a request for that same file comes in. Similarly, in the context of web processing, the HTTP header that files have that are returned to the browser, it's really going to depend on the file itself. So a lot of the fields in there are file dependent. Given that the file doesn't change, the header doesn't have to change. So this is another type of application level caching that we can perform. And Flash does this. Also, Flash does some optimizations that take advantage of the networking hardware and of the network interface card. For instance, all of the data structures are aligned so that it's easy to perform DMA operations without copying data. Similarly, they use DMA operations that have scatter-gather support, and that really means that the header and the actual data don't have to be aligned one next to another in memory. They can be sent from different memory locations. So there is a copy that's avoided. All of these are very useful techniques and are now fairly common optimizations. However, at the time the paper was written, they were pretty novel. And in fact, some of the systems they compare against did not have some of these things included.